tough, tough game for us, and I'm sure for Pittsburgh, Jeff, it was a great game for them. Tempo was the name of this game, and I thought they got the tempo going the way they wanted to, and before you know it, it's one of those teams that it's no whoever had the ball at the last possession, and we saw what took place. And I credit that, you know, though defensively we were okay, but it comes down to making plays at the end. They made some plays. We got tied up with 8 seconds to go. Had a lot of chances to really get some distance with ourselves. And our inability to take care of the basketball. We had 3 straight possessions. I think it's maybe a 5-6 point game. And I thought we didn't cash in on it. And that allowed them to hang around. So got disappointed in the locker room. But at the same time, we know the sun's going to come up tomorrow, and it's not the end of the world. You know, there are a lot of things going on in this world right now, and that are more important than just basketball. So, came up short. Just got to regroup because now that ends the non-conference schedule, and we jump right into conference play.
Take questions. Let's start with Zach.
Mike, when did you find out that Julian tested positive, and how hard was it to, you know, play a game basically without your best player, without basically any practice time?
That's part of the adjustments. We just found out a few days ago that took place, and of course then the protocols kick in, and that's the adjustment, you know, for a team. But that's where your lead scored, but. I told our guys, somebody else got to step up. But at the same time, you know, we're hoping and prayer for that Jules going to be okay, and, as well as all the people that are affected by this this virus.
Here we'll go down with Dennis.
Mike, you talked about not being able to kind of extend the lead via chances. Was it that a byproduct of what they were doing, or maybe your group not making plays, or inexperience?
Just not making the play. That's all. We're making the right play. That's all. I mean, we see we had 4 turnovers, I think, at halftime. We ended up with 14. And we always talk about momentum. You know, we're a team that, you know, our defense is a big part of what we do. And so, then not only that, a chance to score, it really amps up your defense. So it was kind of like shooting yourself in the foot. We had some things like that earlier, and then we got better at it. But I think our guys were trying. And let's give Pitt some credit, too. Because they didn't give up on plays. I mean, you look at the game, it's so dramatic. You know, neither team shot well. They got to the free throw line 28 times. That's double what we did. Almost tripled.
23
of them.
That lies
the game right there.
Mike, on that last play, was that just a kid making a big shot? Because it looked like Joel contested the shot recently.
Yeah, I thought we could have not let the guys have a straight line drive. But he made a play. Let's give him credit. He made a play. Dylan did a good job of getting to the free throw line, making a couple of free throws. And, I just knew it on my heart. They knew in their heart we had another stop at us. And I thought he was there, but you know, it's like anything else. You know, when you let a team hang around, it comes back to bite you, and it did. He made a good shot.
For Posh, you guys forced 18 turnovers, you only scored 9 points off them. What do you think was wrong with the transition game today?
I feel like we wasn't running the floor well. We wasn't getting over the flow. We wasn't always getting turned over. We was kind of slowing it down, not pushing it up, not throwing the head, and that's really it.
Posh, what's the biggest challenge playing without Julian on short notice?
I feel like it's a real big challenge because it's a whole team, so it's not just one player. So I feel like we all just have to come and play today, you know, just try to, like, win the game, and that's really
Their next game against Seton Hall is forfeited, and you got to get Butler next. So what are you going to do with that extra day and just kind of work towards moving on, getting Butler next?
Is there a question for
it? It's for anyone. It's for anyone if anyone wants to answer it.
Yeah, I mean, it's we're in conference play now, and what is taking place in the game, one disappointed we're not playing it, but at the same time, the schedule continues. We jump into Big East play, we get ready to play for a championship. That's going to be our mindset. We got to get better. This one here is as tough as it is, tough loss. We got to learn from it. We're going to do a lot of games like this here where it's going to go down to the last play, last second. Grit and grind, and we got to learn from it. It's like I said, when you got 9 new faces and you're trying to get ready and get a team ready for what's getting ready to take place in the league play, this is epitome of what takes place in there. A loose ball here, a charge there. Think about us getting some free throw lines going down the stretch. Those are the things that we got to watch family and get better at.
Mike, what'd you think of the officiating?
I can't come out and admit on it because I just can't come in on it.
It seemed like you were pretty upset.
On a few occasions with the officiating.
More than a few.
And for Posh, you know, you said, you know, it's a team thing, it's not just about one player, but not having Julian, how do you think, especially on offense, that impacts kind of how you guys play?
You know, Julian is here, he's a great scorer for us, but like I said before, it's not just about him, it's about the whole team. It's not our team, it's we, so without having him, we just try to win, bring him home for him. I know that we have our brother back, but we came up short, but I just feel like with the next man up today.
Coach, transfer of Martez Mathis, having him transfer from Rutgers, having the strength, experience, and athleticism on the floor, how does that help the St. John Hospital team?
Well, I think when he's consistent in his play, I didn't think he played that well. I looked at that. I thought he was timid when he went to the basket, and then he came back, and I thought he forced his couple of jump balls. Makes some good plays for us. But I think we had seen the best of Montez. He just got to be consistent and in his play, night in and night out, because he certainly is a weapon defensively as well as offensively. Again, this team here got to continue to grow, grow into the roles, and knowing that, you know, in our league, especially the Big East, as I said, it's a beast of a league in toughness. I put one word on the word on the board just now. You know, this is where we got to get to. We got to get the toughness factor. And it just can't come from one or two guys. Obviously, these guys here, they bring it. We got to get other guys to bring it.
Take one more. Brian?
I have two, one for you, Coach. First, how is Julian? Is he symptomatic? Is he feeling okay? Or what is the situation?
He's okay. I've had a chance to talk to him. So he's in that protocol. So let's just talk with him. Sure, we keep his spirits up. Obviously, he wants to be here for the team. We know that. But at the same time, he's in our spirits as well.
And what was it like at the